Welcome to Alpha and Arena on the campus of the University of Maine in Orono. Tonight, a hard-hitting Hockey East showdown between the host Black Bears and the visiting Warriors of Merrimack College.
Controls, Larson to the outside. That one not kept in, forced out by Westerlund. Maine with some numbers here. Westerlund in, he throws it in front, score! Brendan Robbins, it's 1-0. Merrimack trying to take advantage. Here's Hennig. Got a defenseman going to the net. Shot in, saved, and knocked aside. Kept in by Carl. And they'll let it go all the way around to Biega. Biega holds, fires, scores. Wow, Biega scoring from the goal line extended. And that ties the game 1-1 with 18:52 to go in the second.
Well, I think this puck just fooled Jeremy Swayman as bodies were falling all around him on both sides. Watch as Maine defenders knock down Merrimack forwards. Biega gathers the puck, tough angle, and Jeremy Swayman fell down as all that was going on around him. Watch as he's trying to track the puck. Players falling down around him, and now he loses his balance, and that's how this went in. It went right up over his shoulder. He lost his balance and fell down.
Comes back out to him. Colquist turns it over. Now here's a chance for Robbins, shorthanded, a burst. He's in. He's stripped from behind by Sini, and that draws a penalty. It's a penalty shot.
Wow. Parallel to the ice, and you reach in at all, you're going to get a hooking call, and that's what happened.
Crowd on its feet in anticipation. Here comes Robbins for the lead. He scores!
That's a goal scorer's move right there. So brave to go to the backhand. Most guys try to go to the forehand. Brendan Robbins, deep left, right, back to the left.
Tavernier, Larson, diagonal pass. They tried to hit Hennig, but did not connect. Tavernier. Now it's Sini. Colquist fires, and that one tipped wide. Tavernier tracks it down. A sophomore out to Colquist. Colquist, Sini looking for a seam. He shoots and scores. Well, Brett Sini has done it all year. His 7th power play goal, 10th overall goal, and Merrimack has tied it up at 2. All right, 4th power play of the night for Merrimack. Here's Colquist on the outside. Sini. Colquist, Tavernier, cross ice pass was tipped, and Sini can't keep it in. Maine has a 2-on-1. Here's Robbins coming in. Robbins fires. He scores. He's got a hat trick, and Maine leads it.
Well, Brendan Robbins is turning into a pretty hot goal scorer. This time he's got Pearson in the middle of the ice, and he uses him as a decoy. Pantano has to respect pass. As you see, Pearson gets the puck up to Robbins. Now Robbins is going to look Pearson off, and Pantano is not sure. He's got to give him a little bit of room there on the short side. He goes upstairs over the left shoulder of Pantano and puts Maine up on top. Short-handed goal for Brendan Robbins, and as you said, Dan, a hat trick. That is just a phenomenal goal scorer's goal.
Mossier back in his own end. Reverses it to Muehlbauer. He starts out for Maine and chips it out to center. Ryan Smith trying to force it in, cannot. It comes to Hennig.
Empty net.
Goaltender is out. Hallway. Now it's Larson. Here is Sini to the outside. Colquist around to Biega. Winds and fires. Save, rebound, score. Ludvig Larson right there for an open net. Tying goal.
Lacroix released off his guy. He thought the play was over. The puck bounced out. Lacroix had him tied up momentarily and released because he thought Swayman had the puck. Turned around, and then that gave him space. You see the shot by Biega. Watch as this puck comes out, and Cedric Lacroix came off his check. And Larson from a really wild angle, it might be between the legs of Cedric Lacroix. We'd have to see it from a different angle to maybe pick that up, but
kept in by Colquist. His shot is tipped, and that's going to bring us to the end of regulation. Here's Veazey coming in for Maine. Veazey moves behind the net. Veazey works it to the outside. Holway, a shot, there score! Game over!
Well, there's a terrific way to end a hockey game for Maine.